Students, we are going to study about adaptation of plants and animals found in aquatic condition. So, as you know that in order to live in aquatic condition, plants and animals, they have some adaptations, and due to that they are able to live in aquatic region. So in your syllabus some plants are there and some animals are there to study. The plants which are here in the lab that I am going to show you, the first one is the plant which show aquatic adaptation, that is hydrilla. Yes, you can have can able to see this hydrilla plant, its leaves. So it is actually a submerged hydrophyte found attached to the substratum by adventitious root. So it possesses adventitious root, means of that it used to attach with any substratum with its roots in fresh water ponds. Stem is soft, slender and bears thin and membranous leaves in whorls of 3 to 8. You can able to see its leaves which are in whorls. It limps when taken out of water, showing the absence of any mechanical tissue. The leaves are arranged in such a way to provide least resistance to the flow of water. They are such, this is one type of, you can say the modification, they lack cuticle and stomata since there is no need of it. The whole plant is covered over by mucilage. What is function? It prevents epiphytic growth and protects the plant against the rotting effect of the water. So you can see it here. Now the next plant, that is Vallisneria. Vallisneria, it is very similar to this. It is also a submerged Stoloniferous flowering plant that grows in freshwater ponds. Stem is reduced and the roots are mostly concerned with the function of anchorage. The leaves are large and ribbon shaped. Like hydrilla, their leaves are large and ribbon shaped. They lack cuticle and stomata. Leaves do not provide any resistance to the flow of water. Whole plant is covered with mucilage. Means the characteristics of Vallisneria is very similar to that of hydrilla. The next plant, that is Pota mugetant. We don't have its specimen. The another one, that is Icornia, which you call water hyacinth, that is Jalkumbhi. So you can see it here. I think most of you have seen Jalkumbhi in ponds. It is a free floating hydrophyte that grows in ponds, lakes, water bodies containing fresh water. When the level of water is low, the plant gets rooted in the soil. The stem is offset, that grows prostrate below the surface of water. It is spongy and stores air. If you see the leaves arise at the nodes in clusters. The petioles of the leaves are modified they are inflated that the and keeps the leaves out of water. So petiole of the leaves, they are inflated and they help it them to be out of the water. Nodes are also bear clusters of brown adventitious roots in water. They act as balancers. The immersed leaves, they have waterproof, waxy and cuticular coating to prevent it from wetting. So all these adaptations are aquatic adaptations. Now at last, Nelumbo. All of you have seen the Nelumbo. I have a structure is there. This is a section of Nelumbo, but you have seen the Nelumbo. It is floating. It is a free floating leaved anchored hydrophyte that grow in ponds and lakes. So its leaves are not here. You have observed its leaves, bigger in size. The stem is rhizomatous and grow horizontally under the mud. The leaves are broad and float on the surface of the water. The petiole is long, slender and spongy. You have seen just below the leaf there is a long tube like structure that we call the its petiole. Petiole is long, slender and it is spongy. The leaves have cuticle and stomata on the upper surface. A coating of wax is present on the upper surface of the leaves, which avoid it in wetting and clogging of stomata by water. So here you will not be able to see its leaves. Since leaves are broader, they used to float inside the water. Now we will discuss one of the animal which is completely adapted for aquatic adaptation. This you can see, it is a fish, rohu fish or Labiorhoeta. Here you can see its body, it is dorsoventrally flattened and it has a boat shaped body. This enables it to swim inside the water against the current. It does not possess head region. You can see a pair of eyes are there and mouth region is there, and just below this head region you can see two gill slits. The gill slits are openings from where deoxygenated water is thrown. Actually the gill slit is there where there is gills region. Gills are present in it where lot of blood capillaries are there, in which blood is flowing, and blood contains hemoglobin. Hemoglobin, when it helps in absorption of the oxygen. Almost you have seen that when the fish is in water, they used to close their mouth very quickly. This is what they are engulfing the water containing oxygen. That water, it passes to the gills region. Gills regions, they have blood capillaries containing blood, and the hemoglobin of that blood, it quickly absorbs the oxygen. Now the water which is inside the fish is free from oxygen, that is thrown through the gills. And on the gills there is a covering that we call the operculum, which protects the gill region. Body, it is covered with waterproof scales. It possesses different types of fins which help it in locomotion and the fin at the tail region, it help is in changing the direction. Some fins help in as a rudder, and so you can see there is lot of adaptation in fish. So students, the specimens which are available here that I have shown to you, okay. Now you can see how the fish and the plants, they are adapted for aquatic adaptation.